Hello children, how are you all? I hope you all fine at your home. I am your English teacher. Today you are going to learn English grammar. The topic is parts of speech. I hope you all learned parts of speech, that is basic grammar. You have learned in your lower classes, but even then today you are going to learn in detail. So what is parts of speech? What is parts of speech, children? Yes, I'll give you the definition. Words are divided into different kinds or classes called parts of speech. That is, all words in the English language belong to a word class called the parts of speech. There are 8 types of parts of speech. 1. Noun. Verb, adjective, adverb, pronoun, preposition, conjunction, and interjection. The first one is noun. N-O-U-N. Noun. What is noun? Do you know what is noun, children? Yes, I'll give you the explanation. Noun is the part of speech that names a person, place, animal, or thing. For example, Ashok is a good boy. Here, the name Ashok is a noun, the person name, isn't it? So that is called what? Noun. There is one more noun in the sentence, that is boy, B-O-Y, boy. That is common noun. So that is also noun. It is also indicates the name. So that is noun. The second example is Akbar was a great king. So A-K-B-A-R, Akbar. So that is what? Noun. That indicates what? Person name. Yes, person. So that is noun. There is one more noun is there. That is king. K-I-N-G. That is common noun. Okay, children, do you understood what is noun? The next one is verb. V-E-R-B, verb. What is verb, children? Verb is the part of speech that names action. So in the sentence, in the one sentence, what is the action? The verb, what the subject or noun, what they are doing, that is called what? Verb. For example, Ria walked to school. Which is verb here? Yes, walked. W-A-L-K-E-D. Walked. That is an action. So that is called what? Verb. Very good. The second example, I am writing a book. Which is verb here? Yes, writing. W-R-I-T-I-N-G. Writing. So that is an action. That denotes what? Verb. So this is verb. Verb is the part of speech that names action. So what is the action in the sentence? That is called what? Verb. The next one is adjective. A-D-J-E-C-T-I-V-E. Adjective. What is adjective? Adjective is the part of speech that describes the quality of a person, place, animal, or thing. For example, Lindsay is a beautiful girl. Here, Lindsay is a girl. That itself, the sentence is completed. But there given, Lindsay is a beautiful girl. So the word beautiful, B-E-A-U-T-I-F-U-L, beautiful. The word beautiful is adjective. That describes the person. So that word is adjective. This is called what, children? Adjective. The second example, Manoj is a tall boy. Here, Manoj is a boy. That itself, we know Manoj is a boy. But there, one more word is added. The word is tall. T-A-L-L, tall. So, that word is adjective that describes the person. So, that word is adjective. Lindsay is a beautiful girl. Not only Lindsay is a girl, she is a beautiful girl. Manoj is a boy. Not only he is a boy, he looks very tall. So, the word beautiful, the word tall is called what? Adjective. The next one is adverb. A-D-V-E-R-B. Adverb. What is adverb? Adverb is the part of speech that adds more information about a verb or an adjective. Already we have learned what is verb and what is an adjective. For example, he finished the work quickly. So here comes he finished the work. Here the we can keep full stop. He finished the work. So we added what? Quickly. So that adds more information about the work, isn't it? So that word quickly is adverb. Do you understood? Yes. The second example is the flower is very beautiful. We can say the flower is beautiful. So we added one more word, that is very. So it adds more information about the flower, isn't it? So that is called what, children? Adverb. The word quickly and the word very is called what? Adverb. So adverb is the part of speech that adds more information about a verb and or an adjective. That is called what? Adverb. I hope you all understood what is adverb. The next one is pronoun. P-R-O-N-O-U-N. Pronoun. What is pronoun? Pronoun is the part of speech that replaces a noun. For example, Leah is an Indian girl. She is beautiful. Here in this sentence, Leah is an Indian girl. The word she, S-H-E, she. Instead of using Leah again, we used what? The word she. So that is called what? Pronoun. Leah is an Indian girl. Leah is beautiful. Instead of using Leah, we used what? She. The word she is pronoun. The next example is Preeti is a good dancer. She loves dancing. So here Preeti is a good dancer. Preeti loves dancing. We don't want to use the name again. So instead of using Preeti, we used she. S-K-H-E, she. So the noun replaces. So that word she is called what? Pronoun. Is that okay, children? Are you clear? Yes. So instead of using the name again, we are using what? She, he, it, like that. Okay, children? The next one is preposition. P-R-E-P-O-S-I-T-I-O-N. Preposition. What is preposition? Yes. Preposition is the part of speech that shows location, position, time or direction. I'll give you the example. There is a bird in the garden. So there is a bird. Where is the bird? In the garden. That word IN is called what? Preposition. That shows the location. The bird is in the garden. Is that clear for you, children? Yes. The second example, the book is on the table. Where is the book? The book is on the table. O-N, on. That is what? Preposition. So that shows the location of the thing, isn't it? So the word I-N and the word O-N is called what? Preposition. The next one is conjunction. C-O-N-J-U-N-C-T-I-O-N. Conjunction. What is conjunction? Conjunction is the part of speech that joins together group of words or sentences. For example, the sky is cloudy but it is not raining. So here the word but, it joins the sentences together. The sky is cloudy but it is not raining. So the word but is called what? Conjunction. The second example, I ran fast but I missed the train. So even though he ran fast, I missed the train. So the word but is called what? Conjunction. It joins the sentences together. So the word but is called what? Conjunction. Is that clear for you children? This is our 8th type of parts of speech. Interjection. 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 What is interjection? Interjection is the part of speech that shows emotion, surprise and such your feelings. So whatever you like, you can express. So it always followed by exclamatory mark. This is important rule you should follow. So for example, hooray, we won the game. So you expressing your happiness, you won the game. The word hooray, H-U-R-R-A-Y, hooray is what? Interjection. Notice that children. So they're given what? Exclamatory mark near the interjection word. So the word hooray is what? The expression of your happiness. So that word is interjection. The next one is what? I can't believe it. So what is there given? You cannot believe that. So you expressing that emotion. So the word what is interjection. They are given exclamatory mark. Third one, wow, I'm so happy for you. So the word wow, W-O-W. So that express your emotion. That is what? Your feelings. So that is called what? Interjection. So they are given exclamatory mark. So the interjection word always followed by the exclamatory mark. I hope you understood what is interjection. I hope you all understood what is parts of speech and the 8 types of parts of speech. So I will just recap again what is parts of speech and the 8 types of parts of speech. What is parts of speech? Words are divided into different kinds or classes called parts of speech. That is, all words in the English language belong to a word class called the parts of speech. There are 8 types, that is noun, verb, adjective, adverb, pronoun, preposition, conjunction and interjection. What is noun? Noun is the part of speech that names a person, place, animal or thing. What is verb? Verb is the part of speech that names action. Adjective. What is adjective? Adjective is the part of speech that describes the quality of a person, place, animal or thing. Adverb. What is adverb? Adverb is the part of speech that adds more information about a verb or an adjective. Pronoun. What is pronoun? Pronoun is the part of speech that replaces a noun. Preposition. What is preposition? Preposition is the part of speech that shows location, position, time or direction. Conjunction. What is conjunction? Conjunction is the part of speech that joins together groups of words or sentences. Interjection. What is interjection? Interjection is the part of speech that shows emotion, surprise and such feelings. It always followed by exclamatory mark. I hope you all understood the simple way of parts of speech, children. You learn it and I'll give you the more examples in your homework. Okay. Thank you. We will meet in the next video class. Thank you.